This lecture is about bada's collection namespace. In this lecture, I will briefly introduce the collection namespace and introduce the iList, iComparer, ArrayList, and map classes. In bada, a collection refers to a group of items of the same type, such as a stack, queue, ArrayList, or linked list. The collection class provides various interfaces, including the iCollection, iEnumerator, iList, iMap, and iMultiMap interfaces. An interface refers to a class where all the functions are defined as virtual functions. An interface can be regarded as a set of functions necessary for classes that perform a specific function. For example, the iList interface is a class that consists of functions that list classes must commonly have, regardless of the implementation method or the data type. Another example of an interface is an event listener. As you can see in the code, if a class is defined as both a form and as an iActionEventListener, even though this class is a subclass of the form, this class can be used as the event listener to handle an action event. The most important interfaces in the collection are iCollection and iEnumerator. iCollection provides the getCount and getEnumeratorN functions. The getCount function returns the number of items in the collection, and the getEnumeratorN function returns the enumerator interface. iEnumerator is the enumerator of the collection and is used to get the items in the collection in sequence. The enumerator provides the getCurrent function to get the object at the current point. The moveNext function moves the point to the next object, and the reset function moves the pointer to the first item. There is a more sophisticated interface, and that's the iList interface. The iList interface provides the functions to add or remove objects, and to get items at specific points, and also to find an item in the list. Additionally, the iComparer interface is defined to sort the objects in the list. The iComparer interface provides the functions to compare objects, allowing the greater or smaller object from among objects to be found. iComparer interfaces are implemented for known types, such as the double, float, or string. The actual implementation of the iList interface is the ArrayList class and the LinkedList class. Currently, the items in the list cannot be stack variables because a memory problem may be caused when a stack variable is used in a list, and because the memory allocated to the variable may disappear when the variable is out of scope. So let's see how we can use an array list using an example. As I mentioned before, the items in a list are created in the heap memory. You can see how we can get the getAt function to get the object at a specified index. You can also insert an object into a specific index of an array. The next example shows how to delete an object from a list. In this next example, you can see how to sort the items of an integer array. As I mentioned earlier, to sort a list, you need to use the comparer interface. In the case of an integer list, you can create the pre-implemented integer comparer class and sort a list using this class. The iEnumerator interface accesses the objects in the collection in sequence. This example accesses and prints the items in the array list on the screen sequentially. Unlike general collections, the ArrayList and LinkedList classes follow the iList interface. They provide the getAt function to get an object from a specific location. The same functionality can be achieved using the for loop of the C programming language. An IMAP is a collection different from a list, as it is used to store key-value pairs. Therefore, to add an object, you have to specify both the key and the value. You can also delete an object corresponding to the specified key. Additionally, functions to check if there is an object with the specified key in a collection and to get the object corresponding to the key are provided. And besides these, functions are provided to get all the keys in the map, to get all the values, to get the enumerator used for the map only, and to change the value for a specified key. While there is one value for a key in the IMAP, the IMultiMap class can be used when there can be more than one value for a key. Therefore, functions to check if there is a specified key and value pair, to identify how many values there are for a specified key, and to change a specified value for a specified key are provided. For a map and multimap, a different enumerator from the existing numerator is required. This enumerator is called IMapEnumerator. The IMapEnumerator class provides functions to get the key or value of the current point. So if you call the getCurrent function to get the object of the current point, the function returns the map entry object. The map entry object contains the key and value pair. Besides this class, there is also the IBidirectionalEnumerator class that enables enumeration both backwards and forwards. The classes that are created by actually implementing a map and multimap are the HashMap and MultiHashMap classes. These classes initially have a capacity to hold 16 items and arrange objects by assigning hash codes to the keys. This example shows how to use the HashMap. First, I prepared the three keys, name, age, and phone, as strings, and added a key name and a string John pair, a key age, and an integer 15 pair, and a key phone, and a phone number string pair to the map. Then, to get the value of age from the map, I called the getValue function of the map, passing the string age. Then I cast the value to the integer pointer to get the value as an integer. This example also shows how a value corresponding to a specified key can be deleted from the map. This example shows how to access the content of the map in sequence using the IMapEnumerator. Although this example is almost the same as that of the enumerator, the difference is that this example gets each key and value pair from the enumerator by calling the getKey and getValue functions and prints them. Besides these classes, there are more classes that are created by implementing the iCollectionInterface class. These are the stack and queue classes. A stack provides basic stack functions, such as push, pop, and peek functions. And a queue provides functions such as the enqueue, dequeue, and peek functions. Basically, since the stack and queue classes are created by implementing the iCollection class, functions to get the enumerator and count using the getEnumerator function are provided. Additionally, the contain function is also provided to check if there is a specified object, even though the function is not in the iCollection class. In this lecture, I introduced interfaces. Bada interfaces are classes starting with I and have virtual functions. The ArrayList and LinkList classes are created by implementing the iList interface class. Each of the classes supports sorting using the iComparer interface. In Bada, all the collection objects can get an item using the enumerator class. A HashMap is a collection type class to save a key and value pair. Finally, the OSP collection namespace also provides the stack and queue classes.